now we have to discuss about the elasticity of demand, right? First, we understand the meaning of this term, elasticity. It means response, right? And response between what? Response between price and demand. Okay, we have already studied the law of demand, that if price of the commodity will rise, the demand for that commodity will fall. Okay, but by how much degree or what change in price can lead to how much change in demand? Okay, that is known as elasticity, right? For example, if I take salt, say price of salt in the present scenario is say 15 per kg, and in a month a family needs 3 kg salt, right? But now the price of salt comes to say 18 per kg. But do you think that the family can reduce the quantity? No. Okay, it needs the same quantity of salt. Similarly, if the price falls to say 12, right, then do you think that the family will increase the demand of salt? No, it cannot use it anywhere. You cannot put 2 spoons instead of 1 spoon of salt, right? So we can see here this response, it is not responding whether the price is 15 or 18 or 12, the demand remains the same, demand does not increase. So it means that response is zero, or you can say that the elasticity of demand is zero in case of salt. Price may change, but the demand is not changing. So this is the basic meaning of elasticity, right? So when you define elasticity, while in some goods you will see that it can, demand can increase or decrease, like in case of the model of a pen, right? If the price increases, you may buy some other model of the pen, right? When you define it, you can define it as elasticity is the degree of responsiveness of demand to a given change in price. Right? So if I say that if the price of the commodity changes by 10% or say rises by 10% and the demand, its demand falls by 20%, it means simply I am saying that the elasticity of demand is 2. It is noted by ED, and the formula is elasticity is equal to percentage change in demand upon percentage change in price. Okay, and you have to remember that it is a pure ratio. Means it doesn't have any unit. Right, because percentage and percentage, when you do them, when you divide them, then they get cancelled. Right? So no unit, pure ratio. And why I am converting them into percentage? Because ratio can be done calculated only when the units are same. Otherwise, price will be in rupees and the quantity will be in units, right? Okay, now before moving on to further discussion about the elasticity, we should first try and understand that how it would it be decided, or what factors will decide that whether the demand for a commodity is elastic or inelastic, right? So first we talk about the factors affecting the elasticity of demand. Right, first factor, simple to understand, availability of close substitute. Right, suppose the substitute of the commodity is available, then the demand is elastic. Called as elastic. If the substitute is unavailable, then the demand is inelastic. Now we can understand them. Simply says that suppose you talk about tea and coffee. if one price of one commodity rises, what you can do? You can buy the other commodity, right? You can respond to the change in the price. While if the price of one commodity falls, like suppose the price of coffee falls, then you can purchase coffee instead of tea, right? So you can change your demands. If the substitute is unavailable, like salt, you do not have any substitute, cannot put anything else besides the salt. So in that case, the demand is said to be inelastic, or you can say cannot respond. Means cannot increase or decrease with the increase or decrease in the price, right? When you are explaining them, you can make it like this, sort of flowchart, and then line you can write, explanation you can write about any one aspect, right? Available or not available. Then second is the nature of the commodity. You can divide it as necessity. And a comfort or a luxury. Okay, the demand for the necessities is generally inelastic. Necessity refers to the basic need, food, clothing and shelter. But demand for the comforts or the luxuries is elastic. You can wait for some time if they are becoming expensive, right? Like for again, you can take the example, the food, for food grain it will be inelastic, but for a mobile phone it can be elastic. Then the third factor is the price level. That means to which price level does the commodity belong? You can again categorize it and into two segments, low price level and high price level. Talk about a matchbox. Say 1 rupee per unit, right? And say talk about a say laptop. Say 30,000 per unit. So if the price of the matchbox rises, suppose it will, and say you are using 10 units in a month, even if the price rises, becomes 1.25, you're not affected. Okay, consumer budget is not affected because the price range of the commodity is very low. But here if the price rises to 35,000, then the consumer budget is affected. Okay, if you are carrying only 30,000 rupees with you at that point of time, you may not be able to buy that particular variant. You may have to buy some other variant, right? So here, for the high price commodities, the demand is elastic. Because change in the prices of these commodities affects the consumer's budget. It's a bigger amount of income, bigger amount of money, right? But here, for the low priced commodities, the demand is generally inelastic because changes in the price of these commodities do not affect the consumer's budget or right consumer's income. Actually, the explanation of the next two points is also based on this logic only, how whether it affects the consumer's pocket or not, right? So you have to understand it. Okay, then next is income level of the buyer. Again, you can divide the buyer into two groups, high level income group or high income group, then you have the low or the middle income group. If the person is belonging to a high income group, okay, maybe say income is very high, 7 lakh per month, then small changes in price will not affect him, right? But if a person is belonging to the low or middle income group, say 10,000 per month, then the changes in the price kya baja raha. So on